I'm reading a verse of scripture in Luke chapter 13. He came to Jesus and they asked a question. They said, one said unto him, Lord, are there few that be saved? And here's the answer that Jesus gave them. And he said unto them, strive to enter in at the strait gate, for many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in, and they shall not be able to. Let's go back into the book of Matthew, and I trust you have your Bibles. I want you to read along with me. I'm going to read Matthew chapter 5, the first verse. This is the opening phrase of the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus said, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Now, there's a lot of people trying to get to heaven, but as we continue to read in Matthew chapter 5, all of that chapter, we go into Matthew chapter 6. Jesus, the sermon that Jesus is preaching on the Mount continues into Matthew chapter 7. And we begin to find out that the way which leadeth unto life, the way which leadeth unto heaven, is a narrow way. And Jesus, as he brings his Sermon on the Mount to a close, Jesus mentions this in verse 13 of Matthew chapter 7. And read it carefully. Jesus said, enter ye in at the strait gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat. Now there's many that are on the way which is a broad way. There's many who have gone through the gate which is a wide gate. This afternoon I'm looking at two gates. A gate that is wide and a gate that is narrow. One leads to life, one leads to death. Verse 14, Matthew chapter 7. And this is important. Get your Bible and read it. Don't take my word. Read it directly from your Bible. Read it directly from God's word. Jesus continues and he says, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life. And listen as we bring this verse to a close. And few there be that find it. I'm talking about two different ways, two different gates, one way or the other. And the way which leadeth unto life, Jesus said, few there be that find it. This way is not meant for many. This is the preaching of Jesus Christ. I'm not making anything up. Jesus said, there's a way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. The question I have for you today, what way are you on? Jesus said, I am the way which leadeth unto life. I am the way which leadeth unto the Father. I am the way, plain and simple, despite what anybody else may be telling you, despite what we hear, what you hear in the news, despite what the government tells you, despite what some TV host or some TV show will tell you, Jesus Christ is the way. There is no other way. Peter talked to us about a right way. He said, there are some who have forsaken the right way. There's a right way. There is a wrong way. Thank God for a way which leadeth unto life, and his name is Jesus. We're going to go into the Old Testament. I'm going to read a verse in Isaiah chapter 35 and verse 8. The prophet is prophesying and he says, and a highway shall be there and a way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. If you're wondering what that way looks like, if you're wondering what that way is or what that way should be, it's a way of holiness. And listen to the promise that we have. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for those, the wayfaring men, though fools shall not err therein. No lion shall be there, can someone say amen? Nor any ravenous beast shall go up thereon. It shall not be found there. Amen. These are not the types of people that are on this way which leadeth unto life. It's a narrow way. You come through the straight gate, and that way becomes narrow. And the prophet Isaiah, he concludes in verse 9, chapter 35, he says, but the redeemed shall walk there. Are you redeemed? You need to be redeemed to be walking this way. Not only that, verse 10, it says, and the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with songs of everlasting joy upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. There is a way which leadeth unto life. Jesus said, few there be that find it. There is a way. It's not meant for many. But it's your choice. God says, choose life. God told you to choose life. And he said to choose life. He says, make your choice this day. In the Old Testament, through the writings of Moses, he said, choose ye this day whom ye shall serve. This is the day. This is the time. Don't put it off. We don't know how much time is left upon this earth. We don't know when God will decide that enough is enough. And he'll come back and make a change for us. Thank God that Jesus Christ made a way for us. The Bible speaks to us that this is a great salvation. How shall we neglect so great salvation. Jesus is that great salvation. There is no other. There's no other name. There is no other way. The way which leadeth unto life is Jesus Christ. This is not meant for many. Few that be. And today, I trust that you continue reading. As I mentioned, chapter 5, chapter 6, chapter 7 in Matthew, we only read 2-3 verses. Read those three chapters. Find out what you need to do to be found on that way, to stay on that way which leadeth unto life, because Jesus said, few that be there find it. And I want to make sure that today you can be part of the few that are on that way. Think about it. Don't waste any time. Today is that day. Today is the day of salvation.